James Webb confirms its first exoplanet. What we know. Welcome to the fascinating world of exoplanet exploration. Today we proudly announce the confirmation of the first exoplanet discovery by the James Webb Space Telescope, LHS-475b. This far-off world is virtually the same size as Earth and lies 41 light-years away in the constellation Octans. The James Webb Space Telescope was launched in 2021 and is the world's premier space observatory. It is equipped with the most advanced infrared cameras and spectrometers, allowing it to make stunningly precise measurements of stars and planets. Scientists are especially excited about LHS-475b because of its proximity to Earth. This makes it an ideal target for exploration and further study. We are beginning to understand the conditions necessary for planets to support life. So every new discovery, like LHS-475b, helps us get closer to that goal. Exoplanet exploration is truly one of the most thrilling endeavors of our time. With the James Webb Space Telescope and other cutting-edge technology, we are slowly unraveling the mysteries of the universe. Perhaps one day our descendants will explore LHS-475b in person. Until then, we will continue to observe this mysterious planet from afar. Join us on a journey to uncover the mysteries of this distant planet and its implications for our own solar system. From transits to spectra, we'll explain the research that's being done right now to unravel the secrets of our universe. It has been long established that our solar system is not alone in the universe, with more and more exoplanets being discovered every day. Today, an exciting discovery has been made. A new exoplanet named LHS-475b has been confirmed by the James Webb Space Telescope. It's located in a constellation 41 light-years away called Octans. The exciting part is that it's almost exactly the size of our planet, Earth, at 99% of its diameter. This is a major breakthrough in our understanding of the universe, and the implications of this discovery could be far-reaching. The planet concludes a full orbit around its star in 2 Earth days, making it perfect for observations. We have been able to observe 2 full transits. Researchers using NASA's JWST have taken an exciting step forward in exploring new realms of science, identifying and studying rocky exoplanets orbiting red dwarf stars. Why is that so important? Although red dwarfs are much smaller and less powerful than the G-type stars like our Sun, they are still advantageous to detect exoplanets due to their size and energy output. Due to the fact that red dwarf stars live longer and have relatively low radiative power, exoplanets such as those in the TRAPPIST-1 system, Proxima Centauri, and Barnard's star are closely studied for the potential of habitability. Since they typically orbit much closer than planets around other stars, they are considered viable candidates for habitability that could exist for a very long time. Check out our video on the TRAPPIST-1 system for more information. The James Webb Space Telescope has enabled researchers to observe planets smaller than Jupiter for the first time, potentially leading to new discoveries about the Milky Way galaxy. With the confirmation of LHS-475b by the James Webb Telescope, scientists and researchers can now begin to focus more of their attention on studying the rocky exoplanets orbiting red dwarf stars. This research will help us better understand the complexity of our universe and hopefully one day lead us to discovering Earth-like, habitable planets. Nevertheless, there are 2 issues to consider with the hypothesis of red dwarf exoplanets being capable of sustaining life. One of the mysteries made is that many of the planets close to their star are tidally locked, meaning that only one side of the planet is always facing the Sun. A planet that is tidally locked could potentially be habitable, yet it would certainly present a challenge. It is particularly significant to note that red dwarf stars emit a large number of potent solar flares, especially during their earlier stages of life. These intense radiation and particle flares could be detrimental to any life on a dwarf exoplanet, and may even permanently sterilize the atmosphere of the planet. Although observations have not suggested that this scenario is certain or even present, red dwarf flaring has been documented extensively. Thus, the flares may have made it seem improbable for life to exist on approximately 3/4 of the stars in our galaxy. How do we detect the presence of a distant planet? One of the main methods is called the transit method. The transit method is a way to detect the presence of a distant planet orbiting a star. Scientists measure the light coming from the distant star and look for regular changes in the star's brightness. If a planet is orbiting the star, it can block a small fraction of the star's light. As the planet passes in front of the star, it will cause a decrease in the star's brightness. By watching for this decrease in brightness, astronomers can detect the presence of a distant exoplanet. So what did James Webb do to contribute? The James Webb Space Telescope is like our eyes in space. On August 31st, 2022, when it looked at a star called LHS 475, it saw something special. A planet was traveling across the star like a shadow. By watching how the star's brightness changed over time only when the planet passed, we can learn more about this planet. The infrared telescope was able to detect the exoplanet LHS 475b by observing two of its transits across the star, thanks to the sensitivity it's dotted with. As you can see in this beautiful plot, taken from the telescope's near-infrared spectrograph, starlight from LHS 475 is being blocked while the planet is transiting it, causing the light curve of the star to significantly decrease. It goes back to normal, which is the first hint that the decrease is due to an exoplanet and not to intrinsic change in the star's brightness. What's the next step after such a discovery? Of all the ongoing telescopes, only the James Webb Space Telescope is equipped with the ability to characterize the atmospheres of exoplanets the size of Earth. Researchers use data to analyze the transmission spectrum of the newly detected Earth-sized terrestrial planet, but are still unable to see much yet, whether or not it has an atmosphere. An atmosphere is made up of different gases, and it can tell us a lot about the planet, whether it can contain life, and how it might evolve. Scientists are trying to figure out if this planet has an atmosphere, so they can see if it is a good place for us to explore. What's a transmission spectrum? A transmission spectrum is like finding out what different colors are in a rainbow. When a planet passes in front of a star, the planet's atmosphere can act like a colorful filter, making the starlight look different. By looking at how the light changes, scientists can figure out what colors are in the atmosphere of the planet. This graph shows us how much light is blocked from a star when we look at the planet from different distances. Different molecules in the planet's atmosphere make the planet look bigger at certain distances. If we don't see any bigger distances in this graph, it means that there are no molecules in the planet's atmosphere. The team was unable to determine the type of atmosphere present on exoplanet LHS 475b. However, they can exclude the presence of a terrestrial-type atmosphere like methane, similar to that of Saturn's moon, Titan. A line that is flat in a transmission spectrum, such as this one, can be quite intriguing. It can provide us with a wealth of information regarding the planet. As this spectrum indicates, Webb did not detect any element or molecule in a substantial quantity. Spectroscopic signatures of hydrogen in the atmosphere of an exoplanet, such as LHS 475b, are typically indicative of a light, gaseous atmosphere. However, these elements were not observed in the exoplanet spectrum. The methane atmosphere indicated by the green line does not block enough light in the 3.3 micron range, suggesting that the planet does not have a methane atmosphere. The yellow line indicates the model, which the best represents a featureless spectrum with no atmospheric evidence of the planet. This model is suggestive of a planet without an atmosphere. The team also acknowledges that while it is plausible that the planet may not have an atmosphere, certain atmospheric compositions, such as a pure carbon dioxide atmosphere, have yet to be eliminated as possibilities. Many debates have been going on about the difficulty of detecting the presence of a 100% carbon dioxide atmosphere. The researcher Lustig Jaeger is saying that it is counterintuitive because the atmosphere is so compact that it is hard to detect using the measurements they have available. The team is planning to obtain additional measurements this summer that may give them more precise readings for detecting carbon dioxide atmospheres. The James Webb Space Telescope has detected clouds on the exoplanet, indicating that the planet could be similar to Venus, with a carbon dioxide atmosphere and thick clouds. The planet is also much warmer than Earth, contributing to the possibility of a Venus-like atmosphere. We've only just begun to scratch the surface of the universe. With the help of the James Webb Telescope, we can now confidently confirm the existence of a planet that could potentially harbor life. We can only hope that future study and exploration of LHS-475b will help us uncover the mysteries of our universe. Until then, we can be assured that the future of exoplanet exploration holds incredible promise. And so until then, let's keep searching the stars and never forget to look for aliens along the way. That's all for this video. If you have a theory on your own on whether there's life outside of Earth, don't hesitate to let us know in the comments. We are interested in what you think. Thanks for watching. See you later.